好，现在我们看一下，在文章中间，冠词 a、the 以及不定代词 some、any 的用法。Lesson 54, sticky fingers, 黏糊糊的手指。Now read the passage for me, please. After breakfast, I sent the children to school, and then I went to the shops. It was still early when I returned home. The children were at school. My husband was at work, and the house was quiet. So I decided to make some meat pies.In a short time, I was busy mixing butter and flour, and my hands were soon covered with sticky pastry. At exactly that moment, the telephone rang. Nothing could have been more annoying. I picked up the receiver between two sticky fingers and was dismayed when I recognized the voice of Helen Bates. It took me 10 minutes to persuade her to ring back later. At last, I hung up the receiver. What a mess!There was pastry on my fingers, on the telephone, and on the doorknobs. I had no sooner got back to the kitchen than the doorbell rang loud enough to wake the dead. This time, it was the postman, and he wanted me to sign for a registered letter. OK, 我们看一下是什么样的故事。标题是 Sticky Fingers, 黏糊糊的手指。Sentence 1 is, After breakfast, I sent the children to school, and then I went to the shops.早饭后呢，我送孩子们去上学，然后我去了商店。看一下 breakfast 这个词， breakfast 表早餐的意思，它是由两次构成的 break 以及 fast。 break 表打破的意思，而 fast 可以表示绝食的含义，打破绝食也就是打破天天晚上开始绝食的行为，这就是早餐的由来。 breakfast 表早餐的意思。那我们说早餐、午餐、晚餐、正餐前面通常不加冠词的 breakfastLunch, supper, dinner, 前面通常不加冠词。好，比如说，正在吃早餐可以表达为 be at breakfast. Be at breakfast, 表示正在吃早餐。好，再比如说，你早餐吃的什么呀？ What did you eat for breakfast? What did you eat for breakfast? 你早餐吃的什么呢？ Breakfast, 前面不加冠词。那么当 breakfast 前面加上形容词或者形容词性的词的时候，前面通常加不定冠词。For example, have a light breakfast. Have a light breakfast 表示吃少量的早餐。Have a light breakfast 只吃少量的早餐。那么相反的 ，have a good breakfast. Have a good breakfast 表示饱吃一顿早餐，早餐吃得很饱的含义。OK。当 breakfast 前面有 good、light 修饰的时候，需要加不定冠词 a。那么另外一个词表示一顿饭是 meal， meal 指一顿饭的含义。那么吃一顿饭是 have a meal， have a meal 需要加冠词 a， have a meal 指吃一顿饭的含义。我们知道早餐是 breakfast， 午餐是 lunch， 那么这两词揉到一块来构成一个新的词是 brunch。 brunch 我们看 br 它是 breakfast 前两个字母，UNCH 是 lunch 的后四个字母，那么放到一块来 brunch 它表早午餐。在美国口语中间，早午餐它指的是早餐午餐并做一顿吃，叫 brunch， 指早午餐的含义。 OK， 那么晚餐是 supper， 晚餐是 supper， 还有个词是 dinner， dinner 指正餐的意思，那么正餐通常在晚上吃，偶尔也会在中午吃， dinner 指正餐的含义。 OK，那么以上是早餐、午餐、晚餐、正餐以及一顿饭分别如何表达的。我们看一下文中的句子。 After breakfast, I sent the children to school, and then I went to the shops. 早餐之后呢，我送孩子去上学，然后去了商店。送我们去上学是 send somebody to school. Send somebody to school 表示送我们去上学， school 前面不加冠词。那么去上学是 go to school. Go to school 没有冠词。另外一个短语是去购物，去商店是 go to the shops， go to the shops。 那我们说去购物是 go shopping， go shopping。 好，以上是本句话中的语言点，我们来回顾一下例句。 breakfast， lunch， supper， dinner， be at breakfast， be at breakfast， what did you eat for breakfast， breakfast， have a light breakfastHave a good breakfast. Meal. Have a meal. Breakfast. Lunch. Brunch. Supper. Dinner. Send somebody to school. Go to school. Go to the shops. Go shopping. 好，let's go on. It was still early when I returned home. 当我到家的时候，时间还早着呢。It was still early when I returned home. The children were at school, my husband was at work, and the house was quiet. 孩子在上学，我的丈夫在上班，房子也非常安静。OK, 在上学是 be at school. Be at school, 在上学。那么在上班是 be at work. Be at work. 这两段中间不出现冠词。And the house was very quiet. 房子非常的安静。So, I decided to make some meat pies. 于是我决定做一些肉馅饼。I decided to make some meat pies. 决定做一些肉的馅饼。In a short time, I was busy mixing butter and flour, and my hands were soon covered with sticky pastry. 不一会儿我就忙着调拌起了黄油以及面粉。很快我的手上就沾满黏糊糊的面糊。不一会儿是 in a short time。In a short time, 相当于 in a short while. In a short while, 表示不一会儿的含义。那么忙于做某事短语是 be busy doing something. Be busy doing something, 指忙于做某事。我忙着调和那个面粉和黄油，黄油是 butter。注意 butter 表示黄油、奶油或者奶油状的东西。For example, he spread butter on a slice of bread. He spread butter on a slice of bread.他把黄油抹在一片面包上面 OK, spread 表示涂抹的意思好再比如说 apple butter apple butter 表示苹果酱的意思那么有个短语是 look as if butter wouldn't melt in one's mouth 表示装出老老实实样子 look as if butter wouldn't melt in one's mouth 指装出老老实实的样子那么人造黄油叫做 margarine margarine 指人造黄油的含义 OK好，回顾一下本句话中的原点。In a short time, in a short while, be busy doing butter. He spread butter on a slice of bread. Apple butter. Look as if butter wouldn't melt in one's mouth. Margarine. Okay, let's go on. At exactly that moment, the telephone rang. 就在那个时候，电话响了。好，我们看一个时间状语。At exactly that moment. Exactly, 起到强调作用，就在那一刻。OK, at exactly that moment. 那么强调我们还可以这样来说 just at that moment. Just at that moment, 也表示就在那一刻。或者还有一种说法是 at that very moment. At that very moment, 就在那一刻。那么注意 very 这个词，它用来修饰名词的，放在名词之前起到强调作用。At that very moment, 指就在那一刻。好，再比如说 very 强调名词的，这正是我想要的书。This is the very book I want. This is the very book I want. 这正是我想要的书。Very 强调 book 这个词。好，再比如说 ，You are the very man I want to see. 你就是我想见的人。You are the very man I want to see. 这你就是我想见的人。Very 用来强调个名词。好，回顾一下这节短语。At exactly that moment.Just at that moment, at that very moment, this is the very book I want. You are the very man I want to see. Okay, let's go on. Nothing could have been more annoying. 没什么比这更烦人的了。这个结果非常的好，大家一定要记下来。Nothing could have been more annoying. Nothing, 用 nothing 表示这是最烦人的，没有比它还烦人的。那么另外注意结构 could have done, could have done.用于肯定句中表示对过去某事的推测。For example, she could have gone off with some friends. 她可能已经跟朋友走了。She could have gone off with some friends. 她可能已经跟朋友走了。OK, could have gone 表示对过去事情的判断和推测。那么 could have done 还能表示过去有能力做而实际上没有做的情况。把表达情感表达更为含蓄一些。For example, you could have done it better.你本能做得更好一些的 You could have done it better 那么实际是你本能做得更好一些但是你没有做到的含义一种较为含蓄的谴责语气 You could have done it better 你本能做得更好一些的好回顾这两个例句 She could have gone off with some friends You could have done it better Let's go on I picked up the receiver between two sticky fingersAnd was dismayed when I recognized the voice of Helen Bates. 我用两个沾满面糊的手指捏起话筒， 当我听出是 Helen Bates 的声音的时候，非常泄气。好，首先注意一下 pick up 短语。pick up 有很多含义，可以表示拾起、捡起、接收节目、接收信号、开车去接某人、通过实践学会或者偶然发现等等含义。那么文中 I picked up the receiver between two sticky fingers， 我用两个黏糊糊的手指夹起听筒、捏起听筒，大家可以想象那个动作， OK， 非常生动形象的用那个黏糊糊的手指捏起听筒来。 And was dismayed when recognized the voice of Helen Bates。 Be dismayed at 表示对什么感到丧气、失望或者惊愕的含义，我感到非常泄气。那么当我听到是 Helen Bates 的声音的时候，注意这个所有个 Helen Bates 的声音，文中用 of 来表示 The voice of Helen Bates。 The voice of Helen Bates 相当于 Helen Bates voice。 Helen Bates voice。那么 Helen Bates 是以 S 结尾的人的名字，这个时候变所有格打撇或者打撇加 S 都是可以的。我们可以说 Helen Bates voice 打撇或者打撇加 S 都是可以的。好， let's go on. It took me 10 minutes to persuade her to ring back later. 我花了整整10分钟时间来劝说她等会儿再打过来。 OK, persuade somebody 表劝说的意思。好，注意这个结构，做某事花费我们多长时间。 It took somebody some time to do somethingIt took somebody some time to do something 表示做某事花费某人多长时间。 For example, It took me 15 hours to reach London. 到达伦敦花了我15个小时。 It took me 15 hours to reach London. OK, 这个结构，花费某人多长时间做某事。 It took somebody some time to do something. OK, let's go on. At last, I hung up the receiver. 终于我挂断电话了。好，注意一个短语，挂断电话Hang up the receiver. Hang up the receiver 指挂断电话。那么还可以这样来表达 Put down the receiver. Put down the receiver 表示放下听筒挂断电话。那么相反的，拿起电话是 Pick up the receiver. Pick up the receiver 拿起电话。那么再比如说打电话中间请稍等别挂断，叫 Hold down please. Hold down please 表示请稍等不要挂断的含义。 OK, 注意这些短语，我们来回顾一下。 Hang up the receiverPut down the receiver. Pick up the receiver. Hold down, please. Okay, let's go on. What a mess. 可真是乱七八糟。What a mess. 这是个感叹句。What 后面加名词或者名词短语。那么再比如说，多糟糕的天气啊。What a day. What a day. 那么因为没有形容词存在，这句话还可以翻译成多好的天气啊。What a day. 多好的天气啊。那么再比如说，多令人吃惊啊。 What a surprise. What a surprise. 多令人吃惊啊。那么再比如说 What 加个名词短语， What a lovely view. 景色可真美啊。 What a lovely view. 景色可真美啊。那么再比如说，多吵闹的噪音呢， What a terrible noise. What a terrible noise. 多吵闹的噪音呢。 OK, 注意 What 可以引导一个感叹句，后面加名词或者名词短语。我们来回顾一下例句。 What a mess. What a day. What a surprise. What a lovely view. What a terrible noise. Okay, let's go on. There was pastry on my fingers, on the telephone, and on the doorknobs. 到处都是面糊糊，我的手指上、电话机上以及门的把手上面都是面糊糊。I had no sooner got back to the kitchen than the doorbell rang loud enough to wake the dead. 我刚回到厨房，门铃又响了，响声足以把死人给吵醒。OK, 那这里 no sooner than 表示刚一怎么样就有的含义。No sooner than 表示刚一怎么样就有的含义。那么注意，前半句是用过去完成时，后半句是一般过去时。For example, the spy had no sooner returned home than he was told to go to another country. The spy had no sooner returned home.Then he was told to go to another country. 那个谍报员刚踏进国门就受命又要出国。No sooner than. 那么这句话我们还可以这样来表达。No sooner had a spy returned home than he was told to go to another country. No sooner had a spy returned home than he was told to go to another country. No sooner 提前的时候，句子强调这个含义，一怎么样就。那么有一点是，当否定词提前的时候，句子要求部分倒装。No sooner had a spy returned home than he was told to go to another country. 把 had 助动词提前。 OK, 注意这一点，否定词提前的时候句子要求部分倒装。好，本句话中间 I had no sooner got back to the kitchen than the doorbell rang loud enough to wake the dead. 我刚一进厨房，门铃又响了，响声足以把死人吵醒。看一下 enough 这个词 ，enough 作为副词表示充分的、足够的含义，通常置于形容词或者副词之后。For example, are you warm enough in such a light jacket? 穿着这样薄的衣服，你觉得够暖和吗 ？Are you warm enough in such a light jacket?A light jacket 表示很轻的、很薄的衣服。那 Are you warm enough? 你足够暖和吗 ？Enough 就是 warm 放在 warm 形容词之后了。再比如说 ，He knows the situation well enough. 他充分了解情况。He knows the situation well enough. Enough 就是 well 放在 well 之后。Another example is the meat is not done enough. 这个肉煮的不够熟。The meat is not done enough.好 ，enough 作为副词表示充分的、足够的，通常放在形容词副词之后。那么再比如说，足够某人做某事叫 enough for somebody to do something。enough for somebody to do something 叫足够某人可以做某事。For example, the house is big enough for three of us to live in. The house is big enough for three of us to live in. 这个房子足够大，我们三个可以住在里面。The house is big enough for three of us to live in. 表示这个房子足够大，我们三个人可以住在里面。再比如说 ，It is cold enough to wear a fur coat. 天气冷的可以穿裘皮大衣了。It is cold enough to wear a fur coat. Okay, enough to do something 可以做某事了。那么再比如说 ，You are old enough to decide by yourself. 你够大了，应该自己拿主意了。You are old enough to decide by yourself. Okay, enough to do something 足够可以做某事了。那么 enough 还能做形容词，表示充分的、充足的，通常放在名词之前。好，比如说，你有足够的时间吗 ？Do you have enough time? Do you have enough time? Okay, enough 来修饰名词 time 放在 time 之前。再比如说 ，There was enough food for us to last a whole week. 有足够的食物可以让我们吃一星期。There was enough food for us to last a whole week. Last 作为动词表示延续的意思。有足够的食物可以让我们吃一星期。OK, enough 作为形容词用法。那么关于 enough 还有一些短语，比如说 enough and to spare 表示绰绰有余，足够而且能够拿出来的叫绰绰有余。Enough and to spare 表示绰绰有余的含义。另一短语是 enough is enough 表示适可而止。Enough is enough 指适可而止的含义。OK, 好，本句话中间另外注意一个短语是 wake the dead。Wake the dead。吵醒死人，那实际指的是声音吵死人的意思，声音非常吵，吵死人叫 wake the dead。OK， 好，回顾一下本句话中的语言点。No sooner than the spy had no sooner returned home than he was told to go to another country. No sooner had the spy returned home than he was told to go to another country. Enough. Are you warm enough in such a light jacket? He knows the situation well enough.The meat is not done enough. Enough for somebody to do something. The house is big enough for three of us to live in. It is cold enough to wear a fur coat. You are old enough to decide by yourself. Do you have enough time? There was enough food for us to last a whole week. Enough and to spare. Enough is enough. Wake the dead.Okay, let's go on. Last sentence is, This time, it was a postman, and he wanted me to sign for a registered letter. 这回是个邮递员，他要我签收一封挂号信。好，注意对，签收一封挂号信是 sign for a registered letter. Sign for a registered letter 表示签收一封挂号信的含义。Okay, that's all for the passage.